Curcumin is an extremely popular supplement these days, and with sales expected to reach at minimum to 181 million by 2030, it's important to know the difference between the options you're presented with. So if you're interested in exploring curcumin supplements, you're going to run into so many options on the market to choose from, sometimes making it hard to pick one and stick with. Well, in this video, I'm hopefully going to make that decision process a little easier for you by sharing with you the five things you need to look for in a curcumin supplement to ensure you're getting the highest quality product. I'll also link below three supplements that I currently like and have taken as well. Also, real quick, before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm, subscribe if you like this type of content, and let's get started. Now, I've made videos already discussing the countless benefits of curcumin in great detail that I encourage you to watch as well. And the research on turmeric is robust, especially studied for its impact on inflammation, type 2 diabetes, obesity, and fatty liver disease, and also autoimmune disease. And of course, ancient Ayurvedic traditions have made turmeric famous for supporting skin, joints, and digestive health. And one thing to clarify, people use the word turmeric and curcumin interchangeably in some studies. This is what gets a lot of people confused when purchasing it. A supplement will specify whether it contains turmeric or only curcumin, which brings me to the first thing I look for in a product. Knowing that curcumin is one component of turmeric, so don't choose a supplement by how much turmeric it has. The important statistic is how much curcumin is actually in the supplement per dose. So the first thing I look at is standardization. Companies that do not use standardization in manufacturing cannot guarantee the amount of active ingredients within their product. And this may already rule out hundreds of products. It's common to see 20% curcuminoids, 40%, and 95%. Secondly, a way to get around the conjugation is very important. And what do I mean? Regular curcumin binds to other compounds when you eat it, making it harder for your bloodstream to absorb it and then distribute it throughout the body. One thing you might be already familiar with is adding it with piperine, which is an extract of black pepper seeds. And piperine helps increase absorption of curcumin, but just know it's not the only way to increase the absorption. Pairing curcumin with phospholipids increases absorption 29 times over straight curcumin. This is especially true if your stomach is sensitive to black pepper. Also, you can find some products that use galactomannans, which can keep curcuminoids from conjugating and making them actually even 45 times more bioavailable. And a quick bonus tip, curcumin is lipophilic. It can only dissolve in oils and fats, so the best way to actually take it is with meals that contain at least 15 grams of fats or oils. Fatty foods such as eggs and vegetable oils, like olive oil, are the best way to combine it. Thirdly, the manufacturer should have a certificate of analysis. If they have a good reputation, they should not hesitate to show you this if you email them. But most of the time, it's actually up on their website. This certificate is a scientific breakdown of exactly what's in the formula, so you can see that no one's hiding anything. Third-party testing is huge. USP or NSF are the two big players here. If they have those, that's a good sign. If not, then at the very least, it must be GMP certified. The fourth thing to look at is, this one can be a little tricky to find out, is the extraction process. You could take a curcumin supplement that had its turmeric processed chemically, but then that raises some other issues like any pesticide use, is it safe, is it good for the environment? There are water-based extraction methods that may be more ideal since you don't get solvents in your supplement capsule or soft gels. And lastly, fillers and excipients. They all have a purpose, often optimizing the manufacturing process or binding the supplement together, right? Fillers are known to add bulk so that your capsules don't actually look empty. Binding agents make sure the supplement doesn't crumble. You see, not all fillers and excipients are harmful, but the thing is, you don't necessarily need all of them either, especially colorers and dyes and artificial flavors. And the jury's still kind of out with magnesium stearate as well, after the whole study on T cells in rats. There's no solid evidence that it's harmful to humans, but if this is a concern to you, then you can find one that doesn't contain any magnesium stearate. And you can find my favorite curcumin supplements that meet the criteria for most of these down in the description below. And no, they aren't sponsoring me to link them down there. They're only there as my affiliates, which you don't have to go with. But if you do, it does support the channel, and I greatly appreciate all of the support you've shown me. Bottom line, not all supplements are created equal, and you'll want to make sure you're buying a quality product. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts about curcumin? Let me know in the comments below. Also, hit the subscribe button too if you found any value in this, and I'll see you on the next one.